Hi friends, welcome to Sudha Learning Hub. You are with me, Sadashiva. Today's session, we are going to learn map interface in collection framework. Map is an interface. We know one thing, map is not implemented from the collection interface. Map is an individual interface. These are the implementation classes of map interfaces. See this picture, this is an interface. All these are the implementation classes. These are the legacy classes of map interface. Directory is abstract class, hashtable and properties class. Now, map. If we want to represent a group of objects as a key value pair, then we should go for map interface. Both key values are objects only. Duplicate keys are not allowed, but values can be duplicated. Each key value pair is called one entry. I can show how key value pairs. It's key. Say value. It's a key value pair format. If for example key is 100 and value is Sadha Learning Hub. Key is 200, value is Srinu like. If key is 300, value is Gopi. But here, duplicate keys are not allowed. Here, again 100. Again 100 is not allowed. See, duplicate keys are not allowed. But, duplicate values are allowed. See, duplicate values are allowed. This is the key and, this is the key and this is the value. The whole key and the value is an entry. One entry. This is the whole key and value is the one entry. Map interface is not a child interface of a collection and hence we can't apply the collection interface methods here. Map interface defines the following specific methods. Those are put method. It takes an object, it takes an arguments to objects. It is used to add an entry to the map. If key is already available, the old value replaced with the new value and the old value will be returned. Now, I can show one example here. If you see this example, I am creating a class called, map. In this map, I am creating a one main method. I am creating an object of HashMap. See this HashMap. I'm creating an object called HashMap. HashMap is an implementation class of map interface. I am putting the values 100, Vijay. This is the key and this is the value. I'm printing the value of M. It prints 100, Vijay. After that, I'm passing M dot put of 100, Sadha Learning Hub. It replaces the value of It replaces the value of Vijay to Sadha Learning Hub. The next method is put all method. It takes an map collection object. Next object get method. Get method is used to get the value. It takes an object argument means key. And it returns the value of that key. And the remove method, it removes the elements from the map and contains key. If it checks the key is available in the map or not. Contains value method, it checks the value is available in the map or not. Is empty, it checks whether the map is empty or not. Size, it returns the size of the map. Clear, it clears the all the entries in the map. Key set, it returns the key set of the map. Under values, it returns the values of the map. Entry set, it returns the set of entry sets we are getting. Next, I'm going to discuss about entry interface. Entry interface, each key value pair is called one entry. If you see here, each key value pair is called one entry. Here, entry is an interface. Each key value pair is called one entry. Without exiting the map object, there is no chance of exiting entry object. Hence, interface entry is defined inside the map interface. Entry interface is a inner interface of a map interface. Now I can show how the entry interface is inside the map interface. See here, it's like look likes. This is an interface called map. It's an entry interface entry. This is an entry is a inner interface of map. All things are here. Next, I'm going to discuss about HashMap. See here, HashMap. HashMap is implemented from the map interface. Is the HashMap is a child class of an map interface. The underlying data structure is a Hashtable. Duplicate keys are not allowed, but values can be duplicated. Insertion order is not preserved and it is based on the hash code of the keys. Heterogeneous objects are allowed for both key and the values. Null is allowed for keys only once and for values any number of values. It allows the nulls any number of values. Now, next I'm going to discuss about what are the differences between HashMap and the Hashtable. Here, HashMap, no method is synchronized. If you see, go through this one, this is the Hashtable, which it's a legacy collection. This is the HashMap, it is a new collection. Now, I'm going to discuss about what is the difference between HashMap and the Hashtable. In the HashMap, there is no method is synchronized. In the Hashtable, every method is a synchronized methods. In the HashMap, multiple threads can be operated simultaneously on the HashMap object and hence it is not a thread safe. We can access the multiple threads at a time in the HashMap. In the Hashtable, multiple threads can't be operated simultaneously on the Hashtable object and hence Hashtable object is a thread safe. In the HashMap, relatively performance is high. Why? Because multiple threads are accessed same time. That's why it is relatively performance is high. In the Hashtable, relatively performance is low. Why? Because it only accesses one thread at a time. In the HashMap, nulls are allowed for both key and value. In the Hashtable, nulls is not allowed for both key and values. Otherwise, we will get the null pointer exception. Whenever we are inserting the null values into the hash table, it gives the null pointer exception. If coming to the hash map, it is a non-legacy collection. It is introduced in 1.5 version. But in hash table, it is a legacy collection. It is introduced in the 1.0 version. Next, how to get the synchronized version of a hash map? By default, hash map is not a synchronized. But the utility class gives one method. HashMap is converted into the synchronized HashMap by using the synchronized HashMap method. By default, HashMap object is not synchronized. But we can get the synchronized version by using the following method of the collection classes: public static map synchronized map. It takes a map interface object. Next, I'm going to discuss about what are the constructors available in the HashMap. There is a four constructors are available in the HashMap. First one is the default constructor. It creates the empty HashMap object with the default initial capacity 16 and the default fill ratio is 0.75. And the next constructor is a parameterized constructor. It takes the initial capacity as an argument, an integer argument. Next, one more constructor is available. The third constructor is parameterized constructor. It takes the two arguments. One is the initial capacity integer value, and the another one is fill ratio. It is a float value. Next, fourth constructor is a parameterized constructor. It takes the map reference object. Now I can show the one example here. If you see this example, I'm creating a one class that is called HashMap demo class. In this HashMap demo class, I'm creating an object of HashMap. It had the HashMap, I'm putting the values by using the put method. It is a key value pair format. Next, I'm printing that HashMap. I'm printing the HashMap. Next, I'm putting the value. I'm putting the one more value, that is Chiranjeevi with 100. The 700 is replaced with 100. Next, I'm get the all the keys in the hash map by using the method key set. It returns the set of keys. Now I am printing the what are the keys available into that hash map. After that, I am getting the values from the hash map by using the values method. It returns the collection object. After that, I am printing that collection object. After that, I am getting the once more time key set. I am getting the one more time entry set. The entry set returns the set. After that, I am printing that entry set. Entry set means the combination of key and the value pairs. Next, I am iterating that entry set. I am printing the values by using the whenever we are calling the iterator method, it returns the iterator interface. After that, I am iterating that by using the hasNext method, it returns the true or false. hasNext method checks whether the values are available into the available or not. If it is available, it returns true. Otherwise, it returns false. I'm iterating. After that, inside of the while loop, I'm creating map.entryM1 is equal to, I'm getting each and every entry. Entry is nothing but a key value pair format. After that, I'm printing the key value pairs, key and values of that entry, m dot key and m dot get key and m dot. I'm setting the values by using the set method. If you want to get the value by using the get value method. Finally, I'm printing the m. This is the hash map. First, I'm creating the hash map. After that, I'm getting the key set. After that, I'm getting the values of that hash map. After that, I'm getting the entry set. I'm iterating that entry set into the by using the iterator interface. Iterator interface is one of the cursor interface to iterate the to get the element one by one. This is the example of hash map. Next, I'm going to discuss about what are the differences between HashMap and linked HashMap. See here, HashMap is implemented from the map, and linked HashMap is the subclass of HashMap. See this hierarchy. HashMap is implemented from the map, and linked HashMap is a subclass of HashMap. Now I am discussing about what are the differences between HashMap and the linked HashMap. The HashMap is the underlying data structure of Hashtable, but linked HashMap is the underlying data structure. It is a combination of Hashtable and linked list. The insertion order is not preserved in the HashMap, but insertion order is preserved in the linked HashMap. Why? Because linked means it is the linking is there, but insertion preserved is there. The hash map is introduced in Java 1.2 version onwards. Sorry, 1.4 version onwards. Sorry for this, I'm doing the mistake here. HashMap is introduced in Java 1.2 version onwards, and linked HashMap introduced in Java 1.0 version onwards. In general, we are use the linked hash set and the linked hash map for implementing the caching applications. See here, the linked hash set and the linked hash map, these are all used in the caching applications. Finally, map is an interface, and hash map and linked hash map, these are the implementation classes of map table, map interface. And hash table is also a implementation class of map interface, but it is a legacy collection framework.
Thank you so much watching this video. Hope this lesson helpful to you. Keep watching our lessons. Keep writing to us. Do not forget subscribe our channel SA.Learning Hub, because we have many session that would help you to develop our skills, and I will be back soon. Till then, you take care. Bye bye.